The CellScapes initiative really fundamentally aims to understand how cells transition from one state to another, especially as they come together to form complex structures that are essential for life. We want to really follow these cells as they go through their journey, through the landscapes of cell state transitions, to ultimately form tissues and organs.
You know, we're kind of at an amazing moment right now. Biology's been growing explosively. We have so much information about what genes are out there, what molecules are out there, what their structures. These AI techniques are amazing. At the same time, we don't have the ability to rationally predict the behavior of a cell in response to any condition. If we add a hormone, I can't necessarily tell you what's going to happen to the cell. I can't control the behavior of the cell rationally.
Most of what we know about cell biology now comes from looking at individual molecules, figuring out what effect they have on cell behavior or cell function. That's been very successful. There's no question that that's been a good way to go. But we have so much information now about so many molecules that it becomes very important to step back and think, well, what can we do with all that data? And ask the kind of questions you actually want to ask, which is, what's going to happen next with the cell? What is it trying to do? And how can we make it do something different?
Atlases provide a sort of catalog of cell types, especially in terms of their gene expression profiles. But what's missing from that picture is the dynamic behaviors of these cells. And one of the things that's going on at the Allen Institute for Cell Science in this new project is really looking visually through incredible microscopy approaches, time-lapse movies, and seeing how individual cells move around. How do they interact with each other? How do they coordinate in order to build larger multicellular structures?
How do we bring these different technologies together is a big challenge right now in the field. Not only do we want to know how the genes are changing and the proteins are changing, but we want to know where in the cell those changes are happening and how that affects the cell, what it does next. Do they die? Do they grow? Do they become a different cell type?
The tissue level is where a lot of biological functions actually emerge. We want to understand our livers and our kidneys and our skin and our brain. All of those things depend on many cells organized together to do things. And so trying to understand the variation in the context of these multicellular structures, that's where it really matters. That's when we get from cells in a dish to actually cells the way they are meant to interact or where they're evolved to interact with each other.
This foundational understanding we are seeking can really influence how new therapeutics, new medicines are made 5 years, 10 years down the road. So we are ahead because we have to be, because that's where basic science sits. And we're very excited about that, not just because it's going to be very much needed for our own work, but because we share everything openly, how we can maybe empower the community, but also bring the community along with us on this journey.
I think the Allen Institute for Cell Science is extremely well prepared to take on this new direction for a couple of reasons. One is, you know, the vast experience of getting to the point where the Institute already is now, that is getting the tools to acquire and describe all this data, puts the Institute in a very strong position. The second is the team of people there who have come together over the years and worked together extremely well. That's something that you can't just turn on at will. Having that in place makes an extremely strong foundation to do this new work. So I think it's the right team building on a foundation of the right kind of science.
So this is an amazing moment. You have the ability to ask questions, answer them, really develop fundamental new insights. And I think this institute is really like a pivotal place in time, in space, and in science for catalyzing this next phase of biology.